Good morning. Today is October 14th, 2020, about 11:15 here in Pasadena, California, in the Rose Bowl Park, another part of the park here, another baseball stadium. You probably can't see that washed out from the sun back there. So today, there was a story, NBC News story, about gifted programs and are they causing, incredibly, are they causing unequal outcomes in the economy? Basically, you know, the hollowing out of the middle class, which incredibly is the conversation I was just mentioning in the prior videos just from a week or so ago, and that resulted from a conversation I had, or several conversations with my friend Keith from SpaceX. So amazing that question is put forward. So the answer is yes. You know, yes, it causes that. The reality is, you know, the economy in the world in general has become very complex. I mean, it was very complex when I was a child, but we had advanced tools provided to us through these accelerated learning programs, and that's why you know, I got to jump on it along with my peers, including my friend Keith, who now works for Elon at SpaceX. So yes, you know, it's a lot like getting a Harvard, you know, scholarship in a two-horse town. So that's the result. So the economy's been getting more complex, and it's been getting more complex faster and faster. And even in the last, I would say, the internet age, of course, accelerated it tremendously. I would mark that official start probably 25 years ago, you know, in the middle of the 90s, 1995-ish would be that. And then it became hyper accelerated from the internet age. I'm sorry, the social media age, layered on top of the internet age. So the, you know, the margins for profit in the economy get smaller and smaller and smaller in the low tech trades, and it gets, you know, the profit margins only exist in the higher parts of the economy, the knowledge economy, they like to call it, one of the colloquial terms used for it. And that, you know, so basically you have to get smarter and smarter. It's not smarter and smarter. You have to build your tools faster and faster in order to keep up at the same standard of living, doing the same things. So farming, mining, manufacturers, those things which are relatively simple at the worker level, the price pressure just keeps going. It keeps pressing those wages down further and further. So basically, you have to continue to improve your skills constantly in order to just keep pace. So that's really the fracture. So where's all this going? Where all this is going is, I believe that because the public focuses so intensely on sports, including all the technicals, all of the, you know, statistics, the all the things that go along with sports, that ability to get a jump, you know, to break out of that trap. In other words, the tools are there for anybody to increase their knowledge base in the direction that they're interested, at less cost than has ever been the case in the history of the world, okay? Not only is it low, but it's low, it's going lower all the time. And as I'm recording this, I just got an email from my friend Keith at SpaceX that they just got their rural broadband licensing, a big part of it approved. So this is, you know, this is all part of expanding access to really rural parts of the world, not just in the U.S., but, you know, but as I've mentioned for many years now, think about, you know, in a grass hut in Africa. So that's, you know, just today they've made there's been an advance there in that direction for them. So I see all these things as connected. So it's a matter of getting everybody connected together. Sports is a pervasive thing. I believe the knowledge gap that's been created for the last, you know, we'll call it 25 years at least, probably longer than that, can be bridged through sports and just by using people's natural affections and affinities towards that. It's not going to be accomplished through gambling, okay? They don't have the money to gamble. I mean, look, if you want an emerging market case of gambling, look at India, okay? If you want to see what happens when you allow large scale online gambling in an emerging economy where people are not, they don't have a lot of resources and knowledge to sort the good from the bad, look at India. And also India just banned online gambling, by the way. That's kind of funny how that news doesn't seem to get a lot of discussion. So there's a way out of this. I experienced this gifted learning program thing. I didn't have anything to do with my native abilities and where I was born. It's just the way it happened. But across my timeline and the things I've seen in this world, I now can understand the problem. And really, the tools exist in this present moment to fix the problem that is causing the political issues, that's causing real pain in people's lives, and that is by investing in sports. Not betting on sports, investing in sports, okay? That's the future. Invest in sports. So, thank you for your time. Stay safe, and I'll have another update for you when I have the next update. Bye.